people do if they have a calling on their life but they can't reach it. I thought, what would happen if I just took a couple cameras and a couple of laptops to Kai Mundi and taught some kids how to make short films?
I think they've got some of the best stories to tell.
Action!
Home was just a thing, like, for people who grew up in the suburbs and stuff like that.
Once the camera was rolling, all of a sudden, they were given permission to speak.
Let's go! Cut, 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 cut.
In this community, you're not allowed to talk about yourself. I held everything inside me. So with film, I learned to talk about myself. For me, personally, it made me feel that I am worth more than what I think I am.
We are doing Film School Africa, we are breaking a lot of barriers. They are being exposed to different classes, different race groups, and different cultures.
I want to pursue my dream as a filmmaker. I want to be a filmmaker one day.
Everyone is an artist in a way, so why not find inspiration from home?
I think filmmaking is a really powerful tool. Not only for people to see their world, but also for them to be able to appreciate what is unique about themselves and their community.
It's a very diverse country, and we get the opportunity to bring that diversity together.
Film School Africa began a little over 10 years ago, and it continues to help those in poverty find their creative and artistic voice. Would you please welcome our Hux hero and founder of Film School Africa, Katie Taylor. Katie, thank you for joining
us.
We're so thrilled to talk about this project.
Thank you.
And it's easy to see why you are a Hux hero tonight. But Film School Africa is quite unique.
Yeah.
How did the idea ever surface to start something like this?
You know, it's interesting. I went on a 2-week mission trip with my church.
Yeah.
And about 6 months later, I felt like I got a vision from God for a short film. And at the time, I was working in Hollywood. I was an associate casting director, which basically means I put actors into movies.
Let me pause here, because I want our audience to hear about this.
Sure.
Casting director, I mean, you go out and decide who gets to be in Spider-Man and movies like that. And that was one of the movies that you helped cast?
Yeah. I worked for really incredible directors, really incredible casting directors, some of the best in the world. Just incredible.
You go on this mission trip and you get this idea. I'm going to do something that has nothing to do with Hollywood.
Yeah.
How'd that come about?
Went back and shot the film that I had the inspiration for, divine inspiration, I believe. And when I went back, I had this young man approach me. I'm standing in a township of about 40,000 people who live in a square mile, so we're talking intense poverty. And he came up to me and said, I'm a filmmaker, but I don't have the skills and I don't have the tools. I just know that I'm a filmmaker.
Wow.
And from there, it just kind of, I started to wrestle with God. I started to wrestle with this idea of what would happen if I took a couple cameras and a couple laptops and started working in a community like Kai Mundi, where I was in South Africa, and had lots of questions about what good it would, you know, first world filmmaking would do in a place that's absolutely poverty stricken. And, you know, over time, I went and spent 6 months there living in the township of Kai Mundi, and God really revealed in that time that it was art therapy. It wasn't just job creation. And they began to heal from trauma as a result. Mm. So after that, I was sold. And from there, we've created 2 community schools and even a college level program where we have students live on campus, food, housing, training for 2 to 3 years. But people out there who support and give, they make it possible for students to be impacted. And I mean, I recently had a young man who was sitting in an interview, and he said, I was an alcoholic, but because of Film School Africa, I became a Christian. I now have a relationship with Jesus, and he got the job.
What's the future for Film School Africa? What do you see happening out there?
Yeah, well, we'd love to be able to expand our campus. We've got 10 students on the college campus, and We'd love to be able to have everyone come in, but we simply can't afford to have everyone who wants to be there be there. And so we would love to have more and more students. We'd love to expand in that way. And we've continued to have now two community programs, and those community programs really can be replicated throughout the continent of Africa.
So, and are you spending most of your time there?
Yes, I live there now.
I'm so glad that you're doing it and that they're sharing it with us. What an honor to have you here. If you'd like to stay updated on Katie's mission in the Film School Africa documentary, visit filmschoolafrica.org. That's filmschoolafrica.org. You might be one of those people that would like to write a great big check and help Katie out. I think she'd be thrilled to hear from you.